Hello everybody, Mr. Hockey, and today we're going to talk about the Nashville Predators signing center Matt Duchene to a 7-year, $56 million contract. Duchene was the top free agent center available, and Nashville took him. 56 divided by 7 is 8, so he'll have an annual average value of $8 million. He will be 35 when this contract expires. Matt Duchene was drafted 3rd overall by Colorado in 2009, and David Poyle, GM of the Nashville Predators, has wanted this guy for a long time, and now we got him, and this is the guy he got. This season, he had 31 goals, 39 assists for 70 points. He's in -3 in plus-minus rating, 8 penalty minutes, in 18-15 time on ice. His career, he has 727 games, played 232 goals, 315 assists for 547 points, but he's at -86 in plus-minus, which means that they're scoring a lot of the time. He's on the ice. He has an 166 career penalty minutes, 18-27 time on ice, and a 48.4 Corsi for, which means that for when he's on the ice, 48.4% of the time his team has the puck. That number under 50, along with his career plus minus of -86, makes sense because they don't have the puck and they get scored on. And that, because of this PK Subban trade and the holes in Nashville's defense, which I'll get into the PK Subban trade a bit later, this could be effective and important. Just as the same with Artemi Panarin, you should watch that video. I will put the link down in the description to you so you can see that video. Both these players coming from Columbus. I'll get into Columbus later as well about what this means losing both Duchene and Panarin. Duchene, I think he's not gonna live up to $8 million a season, because the only reason he's getting this much, and I said the same thing for Panarin, only reason he's getting so much money is because David Poyle had to outbid the teams to get him. But he's really not, I don't think he's going to live up to this. Because a lot of his time was spent, a lot of his goals were on the power play. They were with Artemi Panarin and other guys. Now, if he has to really step up and be the main man here and play a new style of play, how effective is he going to be? And that's what I wonder. His overtime, he had the overtime goal in round 2, game 2. But other than that, what else has he done in his, really, he's never stepped up big other than that game 2 overtime goal against the Boston Bruins in the second round. He hasn't stepped up. There's no history of him stepping up big in the playoffs anywhere. In the playoffs, he had 2014. They lost in 7 games the Colorado Avalanche to the Minnesota Wild. He's never stepped up in the playoffs, and to really earn this contract, that's what he's gonna have to do. The Predators brought him in because they needed to replace the scoring of the PK Subban trade. They got themselves into this funk. They traded PK Subban for Steven Santini, the defenseman. He's going to be in their defensive pairings on the third line. And then they only got 2 second round picks. Those second round picks are probably not going to be anywhere close. They're close to the talent of Matt Duchene. I think that the Devils should have bargained for Will Butcher, or maybe a Will Butcher, someone like that. You traded PK Subban, which means you officially lose the Subban and Weber trade with the Canadiens. Now, when that win this too. When the Weber trade happened, everyone was like, who's going to win? Who's going to win? Who's going to win? Montreal wins now because P.K. Subban is gone. And in replace of him with the cap space, because Subban's $9 million off the books, they get Matt Duchene. And I think this is a bad move for the Nashville Predators, because here's your forward lines: Philip Forsberg, Ryan Johansson, Victor Arvidsson, then Mikael Granlund, Matt Duchene, Kyle Turris, then Kyle Yarncrook, Nick Bonino, Craig Smith, and then Rocco Grimaldi, Colton Sissons, and Austin Watson. So yes, you've got a very good top six, but then on your defensive side, it's not good. That yes, Subban can be flashy and stuff like that, and causes turnovers, and he can be sometimes a pain in the butt, but you need this guy. You had the best top four in the league, aside from Tampa Bay, maybe even better. You had Roman Josi, Ryan Ellis, Matt Ellis, Matthias Ekholm, and Subban. And now that you're breaking it, you had a huge offensive production from those four as of top four. And then you had your last two. Now you broke it up to get Subban. You got Steven Santini in return, but now you've got a bit of a depleted defensive lineup. Santini's not like the offensive type as much. And you got garbage second round picks. I mean, you're talking about PK Subban. If you're talking about, I don't know, just pick a guy. Let's say, I don't know, Rocco Grimaldi is pretty good. You've got second round picks for him. Yeah, that's pretty good. But for PK Subban, that isn't good. And it's a bad trade for the Predators. And they're bringing in Matt Duchene to replace it. You're seriously. You got this. You made a team that got to the Stanley Cup Finals, and you made it better, and you're taking it apart. And I don't see. That's how I see this signing. You took a team at draft day. You had a team that was in the Stanley Cup Finals, that was still developing. They were about to reach their full talent. And now you're just taking it all apart if you're David Poile. I think this signing is a downside. They shouldn't have traded Subban. This was a forced signing because of the Subban trade. And they gave him too much money because they had to, rather than considering their options. Matt Duchene, yes, he wanted to play. It was essentially over because Matt Duchene did want to play in Nashville, but that was before the Subban trade. We were hearing he wanted to play in Nashville. After the Subban trade, maybe he just got sucked in by a GM who wanted him. The only good part for that coming from Duchene, who will be 35 when his contract expires, is that branding him in the Music City of Nashville, Tennessee should serve him good for, like, giving him a little edge to his career. But aside from that, everyone's a loser. Nashville, what, you just essentially replaced P.K. Subban for $1 million cheaper on annual average value. For Matt Duchene, you're going to a team that just gotten worse, in my opinion. And for the Columbus Blue Jackets, the team you left, now with Sergei Bobrovsky probably heading elsewhere, you got nobody. Everyone's a loser in this thing. In fact, in the whole free agency, the first couple days here, I feel that the New York Rangers are the biggest win, have had the biggest win so far, and they not even that great. They're still paying Artemi Panarin a lot of money because they had to outbid everybody, and that even may not end up good for them. Nobody's winning right now. But forget the Artemi Panarin. Everybody loses. Nashville, because you traded Subban to sign Matt Duchene. Dumb move, bonehead. Now, and then Matt Duchene, for being sucked in by a GM who was wanting to do for years, instead of actually exploring your options as an unrestricted free agent, maybe you could have come to Montreal where you needed, where you could have grown your career in the hockey mad town. And I'm saying this as a Canadiens fan, but as an unbiased Canadiens fan, and in the sense that if Matt Duchene came to the Canadiens, then it's a good for his career because you're in a hockey mad town like Montreal, and then the Columbus Blue Jackets, who can't save anybody, and they are just, I mean, now you're going to rely on Pierre-Luc Dubois to carry your team. And the loss of PK adds the pressure on the offense to create. So why does Duchene and the Predators want to put more pressure on him just as he's arriving? I think this signing is not good for both parties. If maybe Duchene waited a day or two and then he's still signed with Nashville, I'd understand. I'd be like, okay, you looked at your options here, you made your choice. But on the first day of free agency, you just go because the GM wants to pay you. I don't think this is good. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Comment down below what you think of this signing. I know I went through my whole rant of I don't think this is a good signing. But comment down below what you think. Tell your friends about the channel. I will be putting the link of Artemi Panarin's video in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I will see you in the next one.